Hi folks, this is Peach Mario with a new series about how can we improve community contribution in the way that the community contribution is independent from the TillyWiki release cycle. So in February there has been a hangout where Jeremy created a new issue about introduce continuous integration. Continuous integration is a process where developers can push something to the main repository and then robots take over and compile the stuff and release the stuff. And if we can do this automatically, then we can remove a lot of manual work. So because at the moment Jeremy has to do all the work manually, but if we have a described procedure how something should work or should be distributed, different users can say, okay, create a pre-release or create a release or something like this. Yeah? And everything should be done always in the same way. In the meantime, a new developer joined the community. it's Luca. And he created an issue which says things that scare off potential contributors. In this case, the original post is about developers. And as you can see, it's quite a long discussion. And it immediately became a discussion about documentation or user feedback. So that's why Luca split it into three issues. One which says, okay, how can we improve user feedback? Which should not involve, compilation stuff and all the things. So in my opinion, it should be as easy as sending an email. And then there is a third post which says contribute to the TillyWiki documentation, where a mechanism is involved that really needs to push something to the main repository. And since February, I was constantly searching for a workflow that I want to have. There was also a little bit about discussion about not licensing, but let's say the community governance, because at the moment everything is governed by the BSD license, and maybe let's say contributions are protected by Jeremy with the review cycle, Jeremy and others. But if the community has the possibility to independently push something, we need some rules. They should be as simple as possible, so that everyone can easily follow them. But there should be also a possibility that we really can, use them in the way that's good for TillyWiki. So, and this is the main reason for this series. It will be, at the moment, I'm planning to release five videos. Six. And the first thing I want to discuss is, a landing page. All of this is a proof of concept. So it's not carved in stone. Everything is meant to be discussed and can be changed. But there is some ideas. I would like to have a new landing page and how it should look like. Then some information about feature requests, how feature requests should look like. The easiest way to give feedback for new users. And the possibility, for example, to create the email workflow for new feature requests. Then there is a little bit about, a suggestion about the governance model. Then how we should, consensus seeking should be executed. And then there should be some rules how someone can become a member with merging rights in this case. So how can we create a workflow that everyone really, or let us say that the community can really publish independently from the TillyWiki workflow. Then there is some information about the TillyWiki as a static site generator. Now we have a very, very powerful tool which allows us to create, single pages or static pages. Then there is some information about, GitLab to-do lists or WebID. Yeah. As I said, everything is a proof of concept, and at the moment I'm using GitLab, yeah, because it gives us the best possibilities where we can have, let's say, everything which is needed for the workflow. Then, as you can see, it goes deeper and deeper into the development area. So there is a developer's workflow, how we can create merge requests, then how continuous integration and continuous deployment can be done. Yeah? So there is a lot of work involved, and I want to show you how the workflow looks like. Really, there should be a proof of concept at the end of the videos. Then there is some, let's say, external tools which we have proposed already. So there is a chat, for example, with Gitter. I don't have it at the moment. Yeah, I will point to the elements, and then I personally would like to have also the possibility for a voice chat, so that's why I did set up a Discord server, and maybe there is some other topics which should be discussed. Yeah, that's basically it, what the video series will be about, and this was the first one, and the next one starts here with a proposal for a new landing page. Yeah, I hope you like it, and have fun. See you.